Hi there. My name is Enno Peters, and I started Shieldprofile 5 years ago. In this video, I will tell you what Shieldprofile is about, who we are serving, and how our products work, and finally, why I started the company. Our mission is to make it easy for anybody with an interest in the Shield industry to understand what is going on. Whether you want to know about how much operators are producing and their well performance, or drilling and completion trends, permitting activity, or anything else related to this industry, we want to provide you with the insights you need. Turning in all the data that is out there into information that you can actually use is the foundation of our services. So who do we serve? So far, we have mostly 5 types of customers. Financial analysts use our services to analyze the productivity of operators and to identify investment opportunities. Operators themselves want to know how they are doing in comparison with their peers, which locations and completion techniques produce the best results, and see all the activity in their area. Third, service companies are searching for more business. They look for the largest operators in an area or the ones that are most active. They can also easily compare the performance of wells they were involved in with offsets. Mineral owners can find out exactly how much their wells have and will produce and run economics to evaluate mineral packages. And finally, traders want to understand trends in well productivity. They also use our supply projection tool to analyze the impact of various drilling and completion scenarios on the tight oil and gas outlook. We are proud to serve reporters from the Wall Street Journal, Bloomberg, Reuters, and others who are using our services for their own research. All these customers use one of our 2 services, Shieldprofile Analytics and Shieldprofile Data. Customers who wish to analyze everything in their own Spotfire or Tableau installation choose Shieldprofile Data. This service allows them to access our database on demand. But most customers opt for Shieldprofile Analytics, which is our online solution, and which you can see here on my screen. By simply using your browser, you can immediately get the information you are looking for. Here on my screen, you can see our online analytics platform. The portal is filled with dashboards in which you can easily analyze all our data. By default, they are sorted by popularity, so the most popular dashboards are shown here on the top. Our focus has been on horizontal wells in the US so far, but we're now expanding to cover other areas as well. Already we include oil and gas production in the Gulf of Mexico and offshore Brazil, and currently we're working on conventional production in the US. The first dashboard allows you to analyze how type curves have changed or compare well productivity between operators or individual wells. Let me quickly show you how it works. Here on the left, we can make our selection by using the filters or by clicking on the map. On the right, we can analyze the performance of the selected wells in a couple of ways. Let me use the Permian as an example. I will remove the wells with the production start before 2012. On the right, we can see the average performance of all the selected horizontal wells in this area. This chart shows the average production rate versus months on production by year of production start. In the cumulative production versus time chart, we show the average cumulative oil produced versus months on production. We can now easily see how average well productivity has changed over time. Notice the major improvements up until 2016, after which the rate of improvement has slowed down. After normalizing the production data for lateral length, you can see that productivity per lateral foot has so far peaked in 2016. This is a high-level result, but we can easily get into more detail. I will now select the core 9 counties of Midland Basin. We can see the over 13,000 horizontal wells in this area, and the graph on the right side was immediately updated. These dashboards are fully interactive, so clicking on the operator will highlight its wells. Likewise, clicking on the vintage will reveal the locations of the related wells on the map. Using the map options, you can easily zoom in to see a small area and lasso individual wells. Instead of grouping the wells by vintage, you could also select two or three operators and group the wells by operator to see their performance. There are many other options, including seeing the individual production profiles of these wells. The data that is visible in these charts can be exported from any dashboard. The other dashboards work in a very similar way, but they focus on other kinds of questions. The total production dashboard shows the total amount of oil and gas produced in a selected area, for example a basin or an operator. The next dashboard reveals the tight oil and gas outlook based on the latest rig count and well productivity. It also allows you to adjust these parameters, so you can simulate what the impact on future supply would be based on different rig count scenarios. The following dashboards cover well permitting and drilling activity. Some of these dashboards use our production forecasts, which we generate on well level whenever new production data comes in. These forecasts are visualized in this dashboard. Currently, they are created for the first 20 years and we require at least 18 months of production data. We're in the process of relaxing these constraints while maintaining a high forecasting accuracy. In our well economics dashboard, these forecasts and real-time futures prices can be used to quickly generate financial metrics, like the net present value of for any set of wells. This is the second dashboard that we'll demo. We will start with selecting the wells in which we are interested on the map. Let me do so for an area in the Bakken. Let me select the wells in this area. They are shown here on the left-hand side, and after adjusting them, you can see immediately the economic results. There are some default values shown here, but they should be revised based on your knowledge of this area. You can set well costs, operating expenses, differentials, and taxes. On the right, you can see the key metrics for the selected wells, which are calculated based on the model. For example, the remaining net present value and gross production volumes. Other overviews are available to inspect these results. The map view allows you to see the key economic metrics on the map. Pricing information is retrieved from the CME, but you can also use a fixed price deck or a combination. Increasing lateral lengths and proppant loadings have greatly affected well productivity in these basins. You can analyze these trends here and see, for example, how the different operators have changed their completion designs and what their impact has been on productivity. If you want to find out the number of wells in a certain area by status, for example, the number of DUCs or the wells below a certain production rate, this dashboard is very handy. The top operators in an area can be easily found with a leading operators dashboard. We also have specialized dashboards in which, for example, the gas oil ratio can be analyzed. We're seeing in several areas that the gas oil ratio is rising and sometimes negatively impacting well performance. The productivity ranking dashboard ranks all operators in an area based on the chosen productivity metric. A heat map shows the exact location of all the wells included, colored by the same metric. This is the last dashboard that I would like to demo to you. Let me select the Permian Basin again. I will include wells from 2015 onwards. Here on the top, we can set our productivity metric. Right now, we are ranking all the operators in this area based on the average cumulative oil production in the first 24 months. I also want to normalize for lateral length, the minimum number of wells that an operator should have. I will set it to 100 to only show the large operators. Based on this metric, EOG is in the lead, with almost 40,000 barrels of oil recovered in the first 2 years, for every 1,000 feet. On the left, we can see all the selected wells, also colored by this metric. Clicking on an operator will highlight its wells. The thickness of these lines usually represents the relative well count. If you wonder how any of these dashboards can be used, there's a help menu available in which more information is shown. All these dashboards are generic dashboards available for all our customers. For a fee, we can also create customized dashboards, which includes exactly the data and functionality that your team needs. So how does our platform work? In the background, we are continuously monitoring the state agencies, like the Texas Railroad Commission, Frac Focus and other sources for new production, completion and other types of data related to horizontal wells in the US. Whenever there's new data published, we process it, fix all the issues we can find, we solve all the puzzles like allocating lease level production to individual wells in Texas or processing directional survey files, many of which are simply scans. Finally, we publish the structured and clean data in our online services. What makes GeoProfile different from other data providers? Instead of overloading you with a lot of data, we want to supply you with exactly the information you need to make your decisions. We are trying to make our service attractive and easy to use. We also care a lot about data quality and speed. We aim for no delay between when the raw data is published and when you find it with us. Our platform is highly flexible, so we can easily expand our coverage and functionality. Also on pricing, we want to be different. You can on our website immediately find out how much we charge and you'll be probably positively surprised. In the remainder of this video, I want to talk a little bit about myself and what made me start the company. I have a background in physics and artificial intelligence. And when the shale revolution really broke out in the US in about 2010-2012, I was helping customers in Asia with designing and implementing information systems. I was fascinated by the impact that the revolution had on the oil markets and the amount of capital that was invested. Strangely, I found wildly contrasting opinions about where the industry was headed. Some were very pessimistic while others were extremely optimistic, but it was hard to find accurate and comprehensive data. Often you would find some cherry-picked type curve when somebody tried to make a point. Coming from a data science background, I wanted to figure out what was really happening in US shale. During my research, I found that existing data providers made it very difficult to analyze data, even though most of it could be gathered from public sources. For something that was so important, I thought it was critical for people working with or investing in the industry to have a better understanding of what was going on. To that end, I started GeoProfile. Initially with a free blog, in which I published interactive presentations, so users could easily figure out how much was produced from these horizontal wells, and especially how good the wells were. This blog is still alive, and on a weekly basis, we share our findings related to one or more shale basins. Rather quickly afterwards, I received tremendous support from people within the industry, and the blog was featured on sites like OilPro. I then teamed up with other people in the industry and we hired an excellent team to develop more advanced analytics and data services on the platform that I already had built. My goal has remained the same, to create transparency by making it easy and affordable to analyze the shale industry. Thank you for watching. Please reach out if I can help you in any way.